My poem, Dangerous World Situation. My fellow world citizens, invasion of sovereign peaceful Iraq was lot more than invasion of Poland by Hitler before World War II. That followed the invasion and destruction of sovereign peaceful Libya, and now the situation in Syria is just the breeding ground for the World War III. 9/11 perpetrators, masterminders, planners, and executors got away with their crimes without 9/11 open public investigation and being empowered more and more as Al-Qaeda, now as ISIS, and they are step by step taking our world at the brink of World War III, the most dangerous situation for our world, because all the superpower and the NATO alliance, they possess the maximum weapons of mass destruction, including biological weapons. So this poem, the aim of this poem is to expose what is really happening, leading to that, so that all citizens unitedly can stop that from happening and we can enjoy peace in our world. Our world never faced such dangerous situation as the Nobel Prize for Peace defied wars against other kind with aggression, gave free license to attack countries for colonization, where UN Security Council consists of mostly old warring nations, possessing massive weapons of mass destruction, including nuclear, biological, and electromagnetic radiation, at the mercy of out-of-control military run by private corporations. Even France has been re-embracing colonial vision, Germany rejuvenating with Nazi ambition, Australia is out of non-alliance for supremacist Zion, Canada is extending support towards illegal allied invasion, Italy is back on stage with fascist manifestation, Russia is embracing oligarchy, void of Soviet Union. Peace Prize giving Norway developed gigantic space-hitting weapon capable of worldwide selective traceless destruction and annihilation, destroying ionosphere for deadly weather control, leading to tsunami, earthquake, drought and mass starvation. European Union is reinforcing Zionist mission, monopolizing world resources, politics and religion, empowering and expanding NATO for endless military action. Vatican and Holy See setting agenda at the United Nations, endangering democratic secularism and state religion separation, encouraging religious racism by divisions and isolations, solidifying religious groupism as Young Men Christian Association, Young Women Christian Association, claiming World Youth Day as Anglicized Catholic celebration. Jesuits are soldiers of Jesus, les Jesus, for evangelization, not messengers of life preached by Yeshua of Canaan. Even Red Cross profiting from calamities and destruction, evangelists scaring citizens with end of the world prediction, World Health Organization exaggerating pandemic preemption, biotech Baxter sent live avian virus to 18 destinations, international court using flawed, biased war crime definition, Pulitzer-like prizes encouraging worldwide journalistic prostitution, scholars and academies known by colonizing funds and recognitions, friendly fires mostly killing true patriots against domination, without 9/11 investigation, felons running government, intelligence and military operations, covert intelligence and mercenaries creating false revolutions, inviting more US NATO destruction and militarization, Swiss bank and offshore banks hiding monarchical corruptions, new Israel fund is promoting the United Kingdom, where Pope and Queen jointly rule all nations, exposing second coming of Christ is not a holy union, a final crusade of barbarism, belittling past crusaders like Alexander, Caesar, Constantine, Pope Urban II and Hitler. Posed by Kolki. The question is why they do that with crusades, Inquisition, World War I, World War II, so many wars since World War II, despite United Nations and World Court. Because I contend that we are the first race in the world and that the more of the world we inhabit, the better it is for the human race. If there be a God, I think that what he would like me to do is paint as much as the map of Africa British red as possible. British journalist, businessman Cecil Rhodes, who advocated in 1877 the British Empire re-annexing the United States of America and reforming itself into an imperial federation to bring about a hyperpower. How? By creating secret societies. Thus, 9/11 attack on the USA was the re-annexation of the United States of America and to use their military for worldwide military colonization with some pretext and ploys. God bless our world. God bless all citizens.